it so hard to say the same thing? Are you so weak to say the same thing? Burn a hole into your apprehensive.
Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. I'm starting off with this primer from Era, and this is a Korean brand that I purchased while I was in Korea. And I really like this primer because it gives you a nice, smooth surface, and it just keeps your foundation on all day. So I absolutely love it. Now I'm taking my favorite foundation at the moment, which is the Makeup Forever. So I'm taking my Makeup Forever foundation, and I evenly just apply it on my face, and I'm going to use my Real Techniques foundation brush and blend it out. So after the foundation, I take the NARS concealer and apply it under my eyes, but that clip got deleted, so I'm sorry, guys. Now I'm taking a Tude House translucent powder, and I'm just going to take this all over my face so that I can set the foundation and concealer. And I cannot skip this step because I have very oily skin, so this step really helps mattify my face. And all the Tude House products are from Korea. Now I'm going to fill in my brows with my Brow Bar to Go kit from Whitening Lightning, and I'm just taking a spoolie and I'm just brushing through the hairs first, and then I'm going to take the dark shade and start filling in my brows. And once I'm done filling them in, I like to go back with a spoolie and just give them one more good brush to blend it all out. I'm going to be setting my brows with this Damone Roberts Tinted Brow Gel in Ginger. Now I got this at an event I attended, and it just matches my hair perfectly and it works really well, so I've been loving this product for my brows. Moving on to the eyes, I'm going to start off with this Milani eyeshadow cream base, whatever you call it. I'm just going to be using it as kind of like the primer, so I'm just going to apply this on the lids and then blend it out with my finger. So the first palette I'm going to dig into is the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, and I'm taking this rich dark chocolate brown. And with a tapered fluffy brush, I'm going to start this on the outer V of the eye, and we're going to drag it towards the lid. Now make sure you don't bring it all the way towards the inner corners, because you want to keep the inner corners clean for a really pretty highlight color. Going back into the same palette, I'm going to take this medium brown shade, and with a tapered brush, we're just going to kind of put that in the crease to blend out that dark brown. And now I'm taking a clean, fluffy brush, and I'm going to blend this out even more. The key to this dark, smoky look is to keep on blending. And then I'm going to go back in with the dark brown color one more time, just to deepen it up a little bit more. Moving on to the next palette, I'm just taking Smashbox Full Exposure Palette, and I'm just taking the dark black color. And with a pointy brush, I'm really going to apply this as close to the lash line as I can, just to deepen up that outer V. And then I'm going back in with that fluffy brush we used for the dark brown and blending it out. And now I'm taking a black eyeliner. This one is from Sephora. It's very creamy and I love it. And I'm just going to tight line and also apply it to my bottom lash line as well. Going back to the Too Faced palette, I'm taking this mauve brown color, and we're just going to pop this on the lash line where we applied the eyeliner, and we're just going to smudge it out, and this is going to make the look extra smoky and sultry. It's time for some gel liner. I'm using my favorite from Bobbi Brown, and I'm just going to take a eyeliner brush and I'm going to create a wing liner like I normally do, but you totally can skip this step if you just like a more natural line. With me, if I do a smoky eye, I really need to define my eyes back with the eyeliner so that I can get some definition up in there, girl. Going back to the Smashbox palette, I'm taking this really pretty frosty champagne color, and with a pencil brush, I'm going to apply this color to the inner tear duct of the eyes, and this will just brighten your eyes and make it look all beautiful. So go ahead and curl your lashes, because we're going to apply falsies just to make this look all extra glamorous. And the lashes that I'll be using are from Velour Lashes, and these are called T.O. And I absolutely love Velour Lashes. If you guys haven't seen my tutorials lately, that's all I've been using. They're 100% mink lashes, and they look so beautiful on every single look that I do. I'm obsessed. moving right along into mascara, and I'm using Smashbox Full Exposure Mascara, and this is a little sample size, and I've been killing it because it's awesome. I'm using a little bit on my top lashes just to blend the real and fake lashes together, and then I smother it on the bottom. And now I'm taking my YSL Radiant Touch Concealer, and I'm just going to use this to highlight under my eyes and on the bridge of my nose. And I'm just taking a big fluffy concealer brush from Sigma, and I'm just going to blend that concealer out, and you're just going to look really highlighted and very Kim Kardashian-esque, if you know what I mean. Once you're done blending out that concealer, I'm going to go back in with the translucent powder that we used earlier, and I'm just going to take the fluffy thing that it comes with, and I'm going to pat in that concealer with some translucent powder so that we can set that. Moving on to bronzer, which is one of my favorite parts of doing my makeup. I'm using a Tude House bronzer that I got in Korea, and it's just a medium tone bronzer. And I'm just going to take an angled brush and contour my cheeks, and I'm also going to bring it up to my temples and on my jawline because we're trying to make the face look as slim as possible. And now it's time for blush. I'm using a Tude House Grapefruit Jelly, which is a really pretty light pink, and I'm just going to apply this to the apples of the cheeks and bring it back towards the bronzer. Now it's time to moisturize the lips if you haven't already. I'm using my Dior Creme de Rose Lip Balm, and this stuff is amazing. Now we're almost done with the makeup. On to lipstick. I'm using the Chanel Charmeuse. It's like a really pretty nude color by Chanel, and I'm going to apply that all over the lips first. And right on top of that, I'm going to use Sweet and Sour by MAC, and this is a limited edition color, but I'm sure you can find a dupe somewhere. It's like a really pretty light peach color. And we're done with the makeup! Woohoo! So we're done with the makeup, and now we're gonna do the hair. I'm using my SKR extensions, and this is in the color Chestnut, and this time the color matches perfectly. And I know I got a lot of crap in my last hair extension video because the hair extensions didn't quite match my hair, but I reordered a new pack and I am in the color Chestnut, and that is the perfect match for me. So I'm gonna start by clipping on my extensions. SKR has really sturdy clips, so you don't have to worry about them falling out at all. I don't even need to tease my hair. The clips are very strong, so I never have a problem with that. Another thing I love about this hair is that it's very thick and it does not shed compared to a lot of my other extensions. So I'm just continuing to clip in my hair extensions. Now, here's a tip for you short hair girls out there. If you want to rock clip-on extensions, you need to go to your local stylist and get them layered, because that is what I did, and that's how you make them look good and make them look real. The wand that I'll be using is the Numi Titan 3, and I'm using the 25mm, and I am just going to clip up my hair, and we're just going to curl in sections. So I take the barrel and I wrap the hair outwards on the barrel, and I hold it for about 15 and 20 seconds, and then I let it go, and then you're gonna get this nice loose wave. So I'm just going to repeat these steps until my whole head is finished. And I'm gonna fast forward through it starting now. Oh, and by the way, if you guys are interested in these extensions, I have a 10% discount code for you. The code is Fashionista, so use it at your checkout and you will get 10% off. And also, SKR is having a contest, so if you'd like to check that out, I would suggest you go on their website and enter. Everything I mentioned in the video will be provided in the description box below. So now I'm going to take Bumble and Bumble Dry Spun Finish Spray, and this spray is very volumizing and it's a dry spray, so it's not going to weigh down your hair. I was just introduced to this product and I'm in love with it. So I'm just going to lift sections of my hair and spray this product throughout my whole head, and it's going to give me instant volume. And next I'm taking Bumble and Bumble City Sweat Finish Spray, and this is going to give me a light hold as well as a bit of separation throughout my curls and some sheen. And that is the finished look, you guys. I know I haven't done a completed look in a while, so I hope you guys enjoy this video. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to press the like button if you enjoyed, and I will see you guys in my next video. Love you guys. Bye!
Let me take a selfie.